Okay, sir. So what can you tell us about today's event, sir?
It's been a long day. Been here since 10 or 11. Very interesting to meet people you read about on newspapers or you hear about them. And it's a pleasure meeting Dr. Mohammed today. And also meeting a friend, Elua Ofeso, reading from his new book, Route 234. It's worthwhile. If I missed today, I would have regretted not coming today.
Okay, sir. So what's your advice for the organizers and to the general populace about reading?
Well, my advice is that the organizers should not give up, because it's discouraging when you're doing things like this and you're not getting support. I think you need more support. If this were to be a musical festival, you'd have seen the whole place jam-packed. So if we're talking about the culture of reading, you must encourage people. And I think parents should encourage their children more. Like I said, John Maxwell said his father used to pay him to read for him. And unknowingly, the father was praying for what he's doing today. Today is a word speaker and will motivate people to work. So we should encourage our children. And reading should be, the internet is, even if I say hard copy reading is going out of fashion. And there's nothing like feeling the sleeves of the paper, the book you're reading. So we should encourage our children, we should take them on tour. I thank God I see a lot of children here today, and I even have a award with some of them. So we should encourage them to read, it's very interesting.
Thank you, sir.
Good evening, my name is Ikor Dianabasi. I'm a writer, performance poet. So today I took a workshop, a poetry workshop with the children at the Green Festival. The workshop was very interesting. We're talking about the topic of loss. So I had a small session with the children. We talked about what poetry is and how poetry can be used to express emotions and feelings, particularly as it relates to loss. And we chose loss because we are doing this Green Festival in honor of one of the founding members of KIDS, the late Mrs. Nike Adeshiri Ojeike. Okay, she was a poet, a fantastic poet. So the session was with the children was lovely. You'd be amazed at the things that children know, no matter the age they are, and how they're able to connect with topics, connect with things going on around them. So even a child who hasn't lost someone close to them before is able to appreciate what it is some other person has felt, is able to connect it with say what a lion would feel if their child dies, for instance. And sometimes you listen to children give you verses, and it's very inspiring. So it was a very beautiful session for me too.
So what's your advice for the organizers?
For the organizers? For of LABAF generally? LABAF has always had sessions for children, and I like that, I respect that. I just wish that maybe a little more room would be created for more events for children. If, for instance, the children could go from workshop to workshop and then have more time to produce things from these workshops, maybe there could be more mentorship from that point onwards, So if the children could have a little more time so that the sessions could extend beyond what they are right now. But even as they are, they're still good, because a lot of children come from different schools.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's fucked up our minds, the devaluer, devaluing our kinds. For how can you not be God when you're devaluing man? Cooking us soft in political cauldrons, and like sightseeing, one step after another, people strolling without their heads, thinking they're fighting all front to being a man before they get done. But life is not shopping, brother. There are two prisons in it. One, you are shot behind bars, living all you need on the outside, too. You're shot outside the class, living all you need in a show glass, and why the silent towers are still on. What you've had under the covers may be real. We found marijuana in a prophet's pouch, the white, the peddler in a village square, and the sun smokes into this gang of thugs, yet we say we want no evil in our midst, behind our backs as shadows laugh. Now it's calm, like the silent signs of music stream beats, waiting for the next pieces of bursting shells, crunching of bayonet, plunging to human flesh, and everybody picks the voice from the bird's mouth and start to tweet. Tweeting poison whose bottle is big enough to host a beast, whose hands stretch to the ends of the wings, splattering black flesh against trees with weapons and mountain pastors and altars are blessed. Put your hands on that piece of flesh. It is hot and quivering. Just now, it was part of a man. This blood is still steaming. It was driven by human heart. Now it's loud. Next hit sold out. Snakes egg stretching out. Climbing the weekly music top chart. Loud enough to make the president dance. The president start the dance. The dance on the grave of growing sorrows. I am not a spoiler of colonization battle won. I have not forgotten my calls with the keyboard as I strike my own bombs. Holding on to what is golden now, speaking my own tongues. I am the backbone of night, quaking the Quakers aside. Cause you see, by nature I get afraid. But nature has yet given me the privilege to act or not to act out of fear. So paint the picture of hell that I've read in Venus, in maggot reading brains, put it to the ragged trousers to philanthropists and to those in the jungles the airlights have baked. Paint it in illusions, paint it in fast, paint it as meaningless as green word, green, cause right here. On rap, yes, to trace the cheek to the sink, to sink in the sharpness of the sand with the best of our kisses, be the ones we've never heard. So paint the picture of heaven that I have seen in your living room, as white as snow, painted in gold that lined the rim of your pole, cause it is true. I can't see your underwears, but I know the texture of the fading colors of mine between the two of us are little walls. One of us is a lie. The terror of knowledge. Thank you.
Lagos, a load of angels, gangsters on the streets.
Oh shit!
Darizan, a round of applause for Darizan. One of us is either a liar, Lagos, or each and every one of us here seated. Let me invite Sheila Sisi to step on forward. Dami Ajayi. I'm gonna go to the
I'm gonna go to the hospital.